Okay. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. Plus, he likes me. And he owes me one from yesterday. I can do this. Come on, dude. Pick up.
Bryce, I got your collector's fee. Coming to get it?
Hey, Frank. I was actually gonna cash in for a favor instead. What do you say?
Never run out of crap, do you? What's the problem?
I need to find that woman who was in your RV yesterday. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I would really appreciate it. I'm your favorite client, remember?
I'll be in the junkyard in 2 hours.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real... That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into? Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing. Favorite jacket. Definitely taking that if Rachel and I ever leave. If Rachel and I were still leaving today, there's literally nothing in there that's worth taking. Better than nothing. Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. My towel's probably in here somewhere. I should just... No awesome pirate towel. Lots of washcloths. No towel. Rose. Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but ready for the best shower of my life. Hot water, don't let me down. I truly hate seeing so much of David's shit around here. What do I feel like wearing on this crazy ass day? Alright, one last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. Huh? Mom usually does my laundry when she gets sick of me not doing my laundry. Maybe she believed me for once about never coming back home. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Huh. Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Who's there?
Hey.
Chloe! Your hair! When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean... I did. But this is... is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
I'm also glad you came home, Chloe.
Sure doesn't seem like home. There's someone else's shit all over the bathroom.
Well, we've always talked about needing a bigger bathroom, haven't we?
Sorry, Mom. Just forget I said anything. I'm not staying long, anyway. Just here to pick up something.
Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
Don't worry about me, okay? I can take care of myself.
Well, will you at least tell me where you're staying?
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you. It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
Chloe. I
don't have time for this.
Now, hold on a minute. Please. I owe you an apology.
Let's hear it.
Chloe, I should not have asked you to empty your pockets yesterday. I was out of line, and I'm sorry.
Okay. Apology accepted.
Really?
Yeah. Good job. And good job, Mom, for twisting his arm or whatever.
Chloe.
What? It's great. He listens to you. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck. Work with me here. Damn it! Better. But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just need to find the right tool for each problem. This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. Definitely see some problems. It's not like I need a manual, but I'm really glad it's here. This thing is going to the fuck up. Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be. This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. Need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. Need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. That should help keep shit distributed. Well, fuck. Go back from whence you came. It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Nothing doing. Maybe. Sick. Nothing doing. Much better. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course. Please, I need you. Yeah.
Junkyard Queen. Where are you at?
Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so... badass. I was gonna say hot. But, yeah. Badass, too.
That shirt looks awesome, too. I might add.
You like anything that starts fire.
Hey. Not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
Hey, I thought we were cool after that Drew North thing. Don't you want to be cool? Gotta say, I really dig the whole tough girl thing. Frank was right about you. How'd you like to work full time for us?
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing. Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you. But he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know, right now, why you give a shit about this woman?
Why do you care so much?
Because fuck you. I'm asking the questions here.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is. Now,
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your pro-
Rachel? As in, Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know?
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
Oh, you fucking bitch!
Huh?